Well, good evening. Thank you and for joining us this evening, and welcome to North Carolina Central University for the third of four public forums, which are designed to garner public input on the qualities, skills, and experience desired in candidates for the position of president of the University of North Carolina system. I'm Scott Daugherty. I'm the State Director of the University's Business and Technology Extension Service, the SBTDC, and we've been asked by General Administration to help facilitate these sessions. They have done so because we've had a significant amount of prior experience going all the way back to the UNC Tomorrow initiatives of a number of years ago, in which we held a lot of community forums to get input on what they expected from their university. And we've done subsequent things, including interactions with the business community to solicit information from them on what they expected from graduates from the University of North Carolina campuses. So first this evening, I'd like to thank North Carolina Central for hosting the meeting and for the great work the staff has done to get us prepared for this evening's activities. Next, just a few words about the university's efforts to secure a broad base of citizen input about the next president of the University of North Carolina. This includes this forum and the others that are being held. It also included extensive responses to a online survey that I understand has had over 4,200 responses across the state, and that was focused on the qualities, experience of candidates that would be desirable for consideration to become the president. Our objective this evening is to hear from as many of you as possible. So we will have to limit the time that we afford to each speaker so that you we have opportunities to have everyone who wishes to speak make comments. I urge you to be organized and respect the time limits which are set. I would note as well that you're welcome to make written comments. Some of you picked up a card as you came into the session that has some question prompts on it. We'd love to have your responses. You can leave them at your seat when you the meeting is over, or you can drop them at the desk outside. The members of the Board of Governors who are here this evening and those participating in other forums really are eager to hear from you and what you think are desirable characteristics for the next president. So I'd like to, at this point, start us off by having Joan McNeil, who's chairing the search committee, to provide opening comments on behalf of the Board of Governors. She will introduce other members who are here this evening, and will be off and running to get your comments. So thank you very much. And
good evening. It's so glad to see all of you here this evening, and we appreciate your being here. I am Joan McNeil, a member of the UNC Board of Governors, and I'm really honored, truly honored, to be chairing the 2015 presidential search process. This is a critically important undertaking for the University of North Carolina system and for our whole state, really. As we seek out the UNC system's next president, our board is committed to finding a proven leader with experience, skills, and vision. The vision needed to build on the UNC's long tradition of excellence and further its mission of teaching, research, and service to the state. But tonight, we are here to listen to you. We want you to provide us with your thoughts about the qualities necessary for the success of the next leader of our system, and this session is being streamed online and viewed throughout the state. Each session will be archived online as well. I'd like to introduce other members of the Board of Governors who are here tonight to listen to you this evening, and they are John Fenebresque, Joan Perry, Hannah Gage, Ann Goodnight, Steve Long, Zach King, G.A. Sawasink, Rayford Trask, Hari Nath, and I believe Alex Mitchell and Walter Davenport, who are Board of Governors-elect. I believe they're here this evening as well. I'd also like to recognize a number of members of the Leadership Statement Committee. If you would just raise your hand and indicate if you're in the room tonight. Great turnout. Appreciate all your commitment. It's a lot of time that these folks are putting in to gathering this information. I'd also like to provide you with an overview of the search process before we begin. Over the next several months, members of the Board of Governors and others representing all of our 17 campuses, including trustees, chancellors, faculty, staff, students, and alumni, will participate in this important task on behalf of this university that we all love. Working through three committees, we will select a search firm, define the essential skills and characteristics that we want to see in our next president, advertise for candidates, screen applicants, and conduct interviews, and ultimately present one or more finalists to the Board of Governors for consideration and election. Our goal is to elect a new president this fall so that he or she can take office in January. You are participating in the first step, which will determine the leadership profile that we use to advertise the position and recruit qualified candidates. I also encourage you to email your suggestions throughout the process. This search process is about finding the next leader who will continue moving the UNC system forward and ensure that our public university and the state of North Carolina can reach its full potential. I thank you very much for being here tonight and turn it over now to our facilitator.
Well, good evening, everyone. Couldn't quite hear you. There you go. Thank you, Joan, and thank you for being here tonight. I'm Brian Shulkin, also with the Small Business and Technology Development Center, and it is a pleasure to be in Durham with you tonight. It's also a privilege to have the opportunity to hear your comments and gather your input that will help define the profile of the next president of the UNC system. Tonight, we're asking for your ideas regarding the next president. What would you like to see, what qualities you'd like to see, and what qualities you think are essential for this person to be successful in that role. Specifically, we'd like to hear what you think the essential experiences are that this person should have, the skill sets that they should be able to demonstrate, the characteristics they possess, and the philosophies that they hold. To help you organize your remarks, we have provided pre-printed comment cards. We've already mentioned those. Those were available at the registration table. And we have several ways for you to provide your input tonight. First and most obvious will be our public comment period. And in a few minutes, we'll invite you to come to the microphones and provide verbal comments. The format for the open comments period is very simple. Each speaker will have up to 3 minutes. And we ask that you focus your comments on the essential experiences, skill sets, characteristics, and philosophies of the next president. Our timekeeper, Fred, raise your hand. Timekeeper will signal when you have 30 seconds remaining and when your time is up. We want to provide as many of you as possible an opportunity to speak tonight, And following a few simple ground rules will help us manage the process and help you get the most benefit out of your time here this evening. So a few ground rules. First, all ideas are welcome. We are not here to evaluate your ideas tonight. We're here to listen. Second, we ask that you respect the speakers who come forward. We'd also ask that you respect the time limits to enable everyone to have an opportunity to speak. We'd also ask that you use headlines. Give us your endpoint of your idea first, provide us a brief headline of the idea, and then feel free to expand on that. But think about giving us a headline first so you can get your idea or your comment in. We want you to provide input only. This is not a question and answer session for our members of the Board of Governors who are here tonight. We're here to listen and get your input. And finally, and you knew this was coming, if you would take your cell phones or your portable devices and put those on mute or turn those off for the duration of the evening, we would appreciate it. In addition to the verbal comments, you may also provide input through a few other methods. Again, you can write your ideas on the pre-printed comment cards, and we have some other methods for you to provide input as well. And I would ask my colleague Carol McLaurin, who is co-facilitator tonight, to describe those to you. Carol?
You can participate using social media here in the room and also the folks that are live streaming. If you look on the back of those comment cards, the hashtag is on there, but you can tweet any comments using pound or hashtag UNC search. I just showed my age right there. You can email using uncsearch@northcarolina.edu, and you can also text 919-590-3630. And again, that's on the back of the comment card. We will pause periodically and read tweets if there's much activity. And just to get a sense of how many people might be making remarks, remember, if you did sign up out front or you did not, you're not wedded to that. If you are inspired to speak and didn't sign up, that's fine, but we just wanted to get an idea. If you are planning to make remarks, can I just see a quick show of hands? That's fantastic. We have two microphones, and if you would maybe line up just three or four deep at a time, there and there, and we'll alternate. Just feel free to adjust the mic. I can help you if you need. But I think with that, we can get started.
Okay, thank you, Carol. A couple of final comments before we begin. We do have a full house here this evening. For those of you in the back of the room and in the lobby, we do have an overflow room. The live stream is being broadcast in that room. It's directly across the hall, 1221, I believe. If you are, and I see a number of folks watching from that room, if you are in the overflow room and would like to make comments tonight, please feel free to come down front, line up at the microphones, and we would like to hear from you. So we're ready to begin the open comment period. Again, I would ask that you come to the mics, form a line behind the speaker. If there are more than one of you at a time, just give the speaker a little bit of space. We would appreciate that. As we begin tonight, as you begin your comments, we would ask that you please state your name, tell us where you live, and tell us a little bit about your affiliation with the university, whether you're student, faculty, staff, or a community member. We'd like to hear that. So may we have the first speaker? Yes, sir. Good evening.
Yes, good. Good afternoon. Welcome.
And one comment.
One comment.
If you would, come maybe for the speakers, come close to the microphone. Again, we're live streaming tonight. We want to make sure that the folks in the room, as well as those who are viewing, can hear you. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. My name's Harvey McMurray. I'm chair of the Faculty Senate here at NCCU. I also serve as chair of the Historically Minority Institution Caucus of the Faculty Assembly for the University of North Carolina. To our dear colleagues on the board, my question, I have a concern and a question. Quite frankly, I'm concerned about the level of transparency in this entire process. My question is, in selecting the new UNC system president, what type of qualities will you be looking for to help someone to re-establish trust in the UNC system and the Board of Governors, one. Second, the historically black colleges and universities, the HMIs, there's a concern that they may not fare well in this new board. So what role, I hope that we understand fully that the value of the UNC system is its diversity. And I hope the new president of the UNC system fully embrace our diversity and really, really understand that we are distinct institutions. NCCU is not a UNC Chapel Hill. It's not a Fayetteville State. We are distinct institutions, and I hope that the Board of Governors, in its wisdom, really make that a significant point in this selection of a new president. And I want to thank you for, of course, choosing the best institution in the UNC system to visit.
So we'll go to the other microphone. And again, if you'll state your name, tell us where you're from and your affiliation with the system, please.
I'm Mary Phillips. I live in Chapel Hill. I'm a graduate of two of the constituent institutions, and I'm a faculty member. A few points. First, a nonpartisan person who has experience with a university and really understands the academic side of higher education. I'd like for it to be a person who knows the mission of HBCUs. Hold us accountable, but don't expect us to work miracles with insufficient funds. I heard today on radio that one-third of the African-American kids in Orange County live below the poverty line. Our institutions are critical to the success of this state and this nation. Many of our leaders come from our HBCUs. Thank you much.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
David Zondervan. I'm a professor of history and soon to be past chair of the faculty at NC State. And thank you for this opportunity to speak. A couple of observations. The first is I would urge you to keep this search as open as possible. I think your consultants will urge you to make this as closed as possible. That seems to be the rage and the vogue in searches at most institutions today. But I think there are many of us, particularly in the faculty, who feel that's a bad idea. It's antithetical to the principles of universities as open fora. So I would urge you to try to not only have forums like this now, but keep the whole process as open as you can, knowing that there are certain laws and confidentiality to be regarded. But I think we close our searches much too tightly. The second point I would make is I would urge you not to fall in love with words like change agent and transformative. They're thrown around a lot, and all institutions have to change. We're in the 21st century. We're moving further into it. But I think that many of us in the faculty would like to know exactly what we're changing or what we're transforming. My third point would be the old phrase, don't fix what ain't broke. The chair of the committee yourself said, we already are a very strong system. In fact, I would say we're one of the best, if not the best, public university systems in the nation. It doesn't mean we can't get better. We should get better. We shouldn't be content. We should always be pushing forward. But I want a leader who's going to move us forward, already building on our strengths, not come in with some sense of, well, you're broken, and I'm here to sort of throw you all out the window and remake this in some way. And I think there's some talk of that. Again, it's gone on at other places like Virginia recently with some pretty disastrous results. So I'd urge you not to do that. And finally, I think what I would like to see in a president is someone who builds on those strengths and is really embraces the concept of the servant leader, and what I would call a listening leader, someone who really looks at all the campuses, picking up on what my colleague Harvey said about the diversity. We are, one of our great strengths is not only all the things we do, but how many ways we do it. We have everything in this system from art schools and small liberal arts colleges to Research One universities. That's remarkable. Almost no other system in the country has that. And we ought to be building on that strength as much as we can. So that's what I would like to see in a new leader, is someone who listens, who brings all the constituents together to create a vision that says, all right, we're already pretty good. How do we become exceptionally good? Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
My name is Jason Beverly from Durham, UNC Chapel Hill class of 01. And a little bit taller. If you take nothing else from what I say, communication. And since I'm not a great communicator, I'm going to read from slightly prepared remarks. The next individual who becomes president will have to work with kind of a motley group of administrators, board members, lawmakers, and the public. And I hope that they're able to communicate the reasons behind his or her decisions in a manner that reflects the level of consideration commensurate with the prestige of a nationally recognized university system. And in thinking about this person, hopefully it's a human person, and I was thinking about who this could be, and I could think of no better person than my grandfather. A great communicator not only uses words, but expresses ideas and actions. My grandfather worked as a professor of political science and later served in the GA at the UNC system. He is a model communicator, not only in his precise use of words, but also in his actions. He does represent, as the former commenter said, a servant leader, serving in the military, serving at the UNC system, and continues to serve at his retirement community, giving lectures on the expansion of NATO without notes, and volunteering as an ESL tutor and hospital volunteer. And while he can speak eloquently on multiple subjects and with an intellect that is unparalleled, it is the manner in which he uses that intellect which sets him apart. He uses it to build bridges, explain, and connect both ideas and people. He's respected by his peers and respectful of those with whom he disagrees. And even at 89 years old, he is still a student with an active mind and varied interests. Those are the qualities that I'd like to see in the next president. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Layla Al-Sharif.
Could you, a little closer to the microphone, please?
Yeah. Is this good?
That's great.
Okay, I'm a little bit short. My name is Layla Al-Sharif, and I am a research assistant professor at UNC Chapel Hill. This is a non-tenure track position. I live in Chapel Hill, and I'm part and member of Faculty Forward, and I'm here with my colleague.
Hello, my name is Dan Bernard. I'm an adjunct lecturer at the School of Journalism and Mass Communication at UNC Chapel Hill. Thank you for this process and for inviting us to have input, and thank you to the members of the board for your sacrifice of time and for your service. We are members of Faculty Forward North Carolina. This is an organization that formed just in January. We represent, I believe, a silent now majority of positions within the UNC system, people who I believe many of whom would be too afraid to speak in this forum for fear that it would reflect badly on them and their future employment prospects. But there's a growing number of instructional positions and research positions that have very unstable jobs, and we are looking for a president who knows that this is a problem and not a solution to tight budgetary times. We are sympathetic with the dwindling resources, but we cannot put this on the backs of instructional staff and non-tenure track research positions. To that end, we have circulated a petition to the UNC committee, community, pardon me. We're gonna present that to you tonight. We'll leave it at the registration table with many hundreds of signatures, and we'll just read it here tonight and then leave it at that. The petition says that the new president of UNC should stand for teaching and learning. As the University of North Carolina Board of Governors searches for a new president, it's time to remember the university's mission statement. Teaching and learning constitute the primary service that the university renders to society.
We are students, alumni, tenure line faculty, and non-tenure line faculty calling for a new president who recommits to this mission by prioritizing resources toward UNC's core mission, student instruction. Making UNC an affordable place for all students by controlling rising tuition rates, increasing transparency by including all faculty in UNC decision-making process. As our mission statement says, UNC's mission is accomplished through instruction. Our next president should lead in pursuit of that mission. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, sir. Yes,
hello, my name is Gerald Myers. I am a rising senior here at North Carolina Central University. And a few characteristics and things I want to bring up for the next president. One thing I would like for the next president to do would be to first to go out to each and every institution and to single-handedly sit in every financial aid office and understand exactly what goes on in those offices. Because a lot of times people sit behind their desk and they only hear what they want to hear instead of actually understanding what every individual student has to listen to every day they go out there and not knowing if they're going to be able to come back next semester. Financial aid is the number one reason why students in the UNC system and system across the nation do not return for college. Understanding that not every child has parents who can write them a $40,000 check every year and who are not dirt broke to the point where they can get grants to come to school. Those people who are in the middle class who are struggling every day, who actually have parents who are only able to pay for 1 year to actually find other ways as far as scholarships and ways that the students can be able to come back. Also to be able to understand the value that each institute has as far as what they have as far as what programs they offer, like UNC, Chapel Hill with their doctor program, NCCU with their political program, NC State with the engineering program, and understanding that true diversity is not based off people's color or ethnicity, but what they be able to bring to the table. A lot of times people think of diversity and only think of race or ethnicity, and not understanding that people, it's the mindset that they have, it's the passions that they have, and it's not based solely on color. So I think that's one thing I would definitely want to see next year whenever the next person is elected, and also to not, I believe it's called right sizing. I believe I saw something online about right sizing the UNC system. I do not believe that's the way to go. I believe that we should find other ways to not only expand the UNC system that we have, but to expand, open more colleges. I don't want to see the UNC system go from 17 to 15, 15 to 13 to being able to make it more profitable. It's not about money. I want to see the UNC system go from 17 to 19 colleges, 19 to 21, and have different diversity across the whole state of North Carolina, so that way the state of North Carolina could be the number one state for education. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Matthew Clark. I'm from Wilmington, North Carolina, and just finished grad school here at the Terry Sanford School of Public Policy here in Durham. I believe that we need a UNC system president who's committed to helping those that need help the most. And I think that means two things. We need someone with experience supporting institutions that historically have served marginalized students in their communities. And secondly, we need a president who understands the enormous impact that poverty has in our state and the role that public higher education plays in fighting poverty. So that's the main thing that I wanted to say to you today, and also thank you for your time and your hard work. I also wanted to second something that was said by the Faculty Forward folks. There are a lot of people in the UNC system, a lot of faculty who are struggling to succeed, and when we don't give teachers the resources they need to succeed in the classroom, then students can't succeed. And this is the bottom line here, you know. Students have to succeed. The students have to succeed because that success is the future of our state, right? And so that's why we need to support instruction. That's why we need to fund teaching in the UNC system. And thank you so much.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Good afternoon. Harris Johnson, class of 1955, NCCU, and left here and was accepted a position in Chapel Hill for 34 years. And I've been involved on this campus and UNC. And I'll make it short and sweet. I strongly recommend that you consider hiring an African-American female president of the system, who I think would bring a certain kind of sensitivity to the system. Now, you may need to do what Florida A&M did. They recruited Elmira Mangum, a Central graduate, who was at Cornell, but they went after her. And if you don't want to go to Florida, you can come to Central and find the female president for the UNC system. Now, I think we need someone who is sensitive to the needs of students, financially and otherwise. And I think that an African-American female could bring this kind of sensitivity. And my employment at UNC was in the Department of Psychiatry, and I think we need to bring this to the entire system in terms of sensitivity to the needs of students and the community if we are to turn around some of those problems we have. And I think we need someone who's sensitive to securing funding for the HBCUs who have been overlooked, kicked to the side, and underfunded for years. And I've been involved in boards, commission, so forth here at NCCU over the years. And I've worked with thousands of students in the community. And I know what their concerns are. And I think we need to address those concerns by listening and placing someone who will be equally as concerned. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, members of the board. I am T. Greg Doucette, a member of the North Carolina Central University class of 2012, and I live here in Durham, North Carolina. The moderator had asked for a headline, and I guess if I were to come up with one for my remarks, it would be honoring the contract. Article 9, Section 9 of the North Carolina Constitution creates a social contract between this state's government and its taxpayers. That contract is broken when funding is cut and tuition is raised to the point where students can't attend a university or they're enrolled and have to drop out. Now, I don't believe anyone in this room would debate that the current General Assembly has not been as protective of that commitment as they used to be. And the fact is, you now have men and women, mothers and fathers, taxpayers all, paying, financing this government in the hope that their sons and daughters can afford to attend and graduate from an institution within the University of North Carolina. Whatever president you hire, whether they come from the academy or come from business, needs to be committed to that obligation. And if the General Assembly is not going to be, they need to be able to convince the General Assembly to do so. Because otherwise, you're going to have people, the future of this state, who can't afford to attend the institutions that their parents finance. Thank you.
Good evening, and thank you for this forum. My name is Jim Martin. I'm a professor of chemistry at NC State University. I also serve as the parliamentarian for the UNC System Faculty Assembly. Tonight, you ask us to consider what are the characteristics that we need in a new president. But I'd like us to step back one step prior to that and recognize that the people of North Carolina, the faculties of this great university, the administrations of this university, did not ask for a change in the presidency of this great university. We have heard the language, as was mentioned earlier, that we may need a change agent. Change for what? For what purpose? Change by itself without purpose or vision is chaotic and destructive. In university leadership, more than change, we need vision. With vision, when there is a need for change, it will happen. Without vision, change destroys. Finally, I'd like to note that with respect to the policy and highest priorities for the president of such a great system, we need a president who is committed to comprehensive education. Too often in modern discussions of higher education, in fact, all education, we hear the buzzword of relevance. I think any student of any level of history must recognize that if the university were not relevant, it would not have lasted for millennia. Why is the university relevant? Because of its strength in diversity. A little bit of everything is covered. When I was chair of the faculty at NC State University, we were going through the UNC Tomorrow process. And I held some hearings on my campus to get our faculty response. And I'd like to leave you with a thought that came from Dean Jeffrey Braden, Dean of our College of Humanities and Social Sciences. In that forum, he asked us all, would not Islamic and Arabic studies be considered an ivory tower pursuit? At least on September 10th of 2011, the very next day, that ivory tower pursuit became intensely relevant. Had we not had a comprehensive university, we would not have been dynamic and flexible. We're flexible because of our diversity. That gives us strength. So when you talk of relevance for a university, remember the millennia that made her strong, that you bring together a collection of eclectic, diverse people working on things that may be esoteric today, but are highly relevant tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Olivia Robinson. I currently serve as the student body president here at North Carolina Central University. And one of the things I really would like to point out that I would like to see in the next president, I think that one of their highest priorities should be to push and advocate for a student vote on the Board of Governors. There would be no university, no UNC, or anything without students. Our voices matter and our opinions matter, and I think that that's something that's very important that should be offered to the student body president of the association. If not most of the student body presidents within the UNC system hold votes on their board of trustees, why then would we not allow the student body president of the UNC system to hold a vote on the Board of Governors? I think that's something that's very important and that should be explored by our next UNC system president. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Good evening. My name is Sheldon Numba, and I'm a senior in the Department of Theater and Dance here at North Carolina Central University. I want somebody that's here and cares about the students. Somebody that is for the students 110%, because without the students, you have no one to attend your university. The purpose of college, to me, my personal opinion, it's supposed to train young minds full of potential, youth, vitality, and so much spunk and passion to do better in life. And it gets frustrated to do that when fundings are put towards other places. For example, I feel funding should be put towards the departments that these students are in and not towards things like a $56 million student union, so to say. I feel, this is my opinion, I'm not a treasurer, I'm not a mathematician or anything like that, but I believe that the tuition increase should be put into a pool of money until the student reaches or declares their major, and then the funding goes to their major or their department. Because a lot of departments are getting cut because of inadequate funding, and without funding, it's hard for departments to reach out and to expand themselves. So, thank you.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Yes, my name is Roger Robinson. I'm from Saxapaha, North Carolina. I'm not a native North Carolinian. I moved here 13 years ago for a variety of reasons. I am retired from a Midwest university. I knew about UNC long before I came. You have an incredible reputation here with your university system. In fact, I think the last I saw, 5 of your 17 schools are ranked in the top 100 of America. That is quite a legacy for whoever did that, and we could name several people. I would want in a new president, even though, as I said, I'm not a native, but I do live here now, and I take you on as my state. I got here as quickly as I could after I after I retired. I'd like a president to know about UNC's greatness and actually be able to articulate it and who was involved in that. I'd like them to know what a university is historically. It's a unique, incredible institution, and we could go on about that for a long time. I would like them to know what the value of a liberal education is in a democracy. Being educated is not just being able to get a job. Getting a job is very important, but that's just the start. That's almost the end point in a way. And I'd like them, as many have already said, to have the proper communication skills, to be able to do strategic planning, to be able to foster mutual respect and cooperation, to be flexible, and to have very high level of integrity that you have vetted carefully on any candidates that you see, because they're going to need it in the coming days around here. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Hi, everyone. My name is Isaac Earnhardt. I'm a recent graduate of UNC Chapel Hill. What I would like to see in the next UNC system president is a commitment to the publicness of the university in a number of dimensions. The first is publicness in terms of accessibility. This is a public university. This is a public university system. The North Carolina Constitution dictates that it be as free as practicable. I want a UNC system president who will work to ensure that by trying to secure funding on the legislative level, but also making sure that our financial aid policies are committed to making sure that students have access to funding, and that on campuses where there is significant financial aid provided, that policies like the cap that was instituted last year don't go into effect or don't or aren't extended in negative ways. The second dimension of publicness that I'd like to see is a commitment to public service. The university itself is a public service. It is something that is there for social uplift, and so on one level that means a commitment to the university as a place that's provided by the taxpayers and the government of North Carolina to help students and prepare them to not only get jobs but be servants of the state on a number of dimensions. But it also means making sure that the services and research and faculty and student capacities at the universities are able to be deployed for the ends of public service. And third, and for me, perhaps closest to my heart, is I want the university to remain a place for public discussion. And in some cases, although the Board of Governors clearly didn't agree earlier this year, for advocacy. The university should remain a place where academic freedom is valued, where professors and students have the capacity to speak out without fear of reprisal. I want a UNC president who will work to guarantee that. Thanks.
Thank you. Good evening. I am Amari Collins, a senior English major from Charlotte, North Carolina, and I also serve as Mr. North Carolina Central University. Some things I like to see within the new president is for he or she to really understand the importance, the values, and the positive effects HBCUs have on our world, our economy, and most importantly, our graduates that graduate from HBCUs. Next, I would like the president to be inclusive to all universities in regards to funding, resources, and opportunities, so all universities can equally flourish throughout the world. So that's it. Thank you.
Thank you.
My name is Nancy Farmer. I have 3 degrees from the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill. Tom Ross, our current president, is as close to William Friday as we have had in recent years. And I have no information as to the reason for his termination. Please use his qualities as a guideline. His experience, his knowledge, his ability to work with all interest groups, and his dedication to the broad goals of a university education. Like many across the state, I am deeply concerned about the outcomes of this process. Thank you for the opportunity to speak.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Ezra Pickett. I currently serve as the Director of University Affairs for this upcoming school year. I'll keep my statement pretty short. First of all, I want to thank you all for coming today and hearing what we have to say. I hope that our next president will be more inclusive with our HBCUs. And we look at the numbers. We always get increased budget cuts, and it's very hard to pull a miracle without the proper funding. And I hope that our next president will also be open to new ideas of growth and accept the input of our ASG president, because he does bring out all the opinions from our respective student body presidents to our ASG meetings. We meet once a month. We're trying to push for a vote on there so that we all can have some sort of a say on what's going on with our state and our UNC system. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Good evening. My name is Bernard Anthony Holliday. I reside in Granville County, Creedmoor, small town. I have many relatives who matriculated to North Carolina Central University and have had illustrious careers. I submit to this august body the concept of think tank. It's not a convoluted term. Think tank, to break it down, past reflection, present priorities, and future projections. I'll highlight briefly the simple truth. Most of our students in the state of North Carolina come to our university system by way of the public schools and a few private charter schools included. Many of them come with many deficiencies. It is up to the system to intercede and provide the resources and the instruction so that the graduating students, using the timeline of 6 years, will graduate with quality credentials. On the 6-year graduation rate, it's an abomination. It's in need of major surgery, a great challenge for the new president. Second to that is our health disparities. Unless we have a healthy population attracting industry to our state, will be catch up. Finally, on that note, President Barack H. Obama has announced high-tech center coming to Raleigh. It's incumbent on the new president to be visionary, to include all institutions of higher learning, to be partners in this enterprise so that we can indeed be competitive locally, nationally, and internationally. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Good evening. Is that good?
All right. You have to get really close.
I think I'm now. Is that good? Yeah. I'm Allison Green, and I am a Durham native. I believe I attended Hillside High School right on this spot in the old days, and I spent many years at UNC Chapel Hill earning my master's and PhD, and for the last 8 years, I have served as a teaching faculty member at NC State. I am an anthropologist and a member of the College of Humanities and Social Science. What I hope for in the experience and skills of the next president are much. I dream of a new Bill Friday. Well, good luck. But I want someone with an expansive vision of the tradition of the university, 220 years plus here in North Carolina. I want someone who knows the deep history of our state, who understands our state. They don't have to be a native, but I want them to be very concerned about our state's population and our state in detail from the mountains to the sea. And I also hope that the person has an absolute deep drive to serve the people of North Carolina. Everybody's already said that. But the characteristics that I think are essential is that the new president must understand that a broad-based education is essential, a broad-based learning community that values all subject areas. Now, I work at the Technology and Industry University. I'm very proud of that. But as I tell my students in my regular course, Technology and Society and Culture, is that without the humanities, without history, without critical thinking, analysis, writing skills, you wouldn't go far. Okay. So all areas are very important. I'm very sorry to see shrinkage in the humanities and social science, because if you don't expand and develop humanities and social science, you're shrinking the capacities of the population. However, although I'm a teaching faculty member, I also truly value research and extension, and these are other parts of our mission. So I hope that the next university president understands that while the university is a primary motor of the state's economy, it is not a business. It is not a business. It is a place where we invest to improve the lives of North Carolinians and of all members of the nation and state with our research and our discoveries. All right, I thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Faye Calhoun. I am the STEM program director here at NCCU. I came here as from the National Institutes of Health. I was there about 25 years. I retired as the deputy director of one of the institutes there. What we need is a new president with an understanding of what it takes to build and sustain a UNC system-wide research enterprise, okay? And you've got a couple of, or we have a couple of level one, research institutes. They're level one compared to what? I happen to know that. I happen to know compared to what? They can do so much better. The research that they have developed is in small pocket areas. They do some partnerships and some collaborations, but not nearly what they should do to capitalize on the untapped resources within the system. So what we need is someone who can bring that together. What you need is, what you have is untapped potential to bring in lots and lots of funding for many, many resources that could offset some of the hits that we're taking from the state cutting our budget, etc. So the research enterprise is critical to the success of the UNC system, not individual campuses. Campuses should be, the president should encourage and should reward campuses in partnering and collaborating across the various departments, from the arts to the sciences and to the research. The second reason we need to do this is because within our system, we are encouraging, cajoling, and trying our best to graduate majors in the sciences. And yet, those that we graduate that work in our laboratories are suffering. They do not have the support, the job security, or the funding that's needed for them to live a respectable life in North Carolina. So I ask you, please, to inquire with all of the candidates that come before you what they know about a building and sustaining a research enterprise across the system. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening. Good evening. Thank you very much. My name is Coracole McFadden. I am an Eagle two times and a public servant. First of all, let me take this opportunity to thank you for coming to Durham on behalf of the greatest mayor in this entire world, William Bell, who could not be here this evening. I believe that we need, and I've heard some of what I'm going to say, but I think we need a compassionate servant leader who values diversity. One with strong faith, very strong faith, whose faith will assure and promote fairness and justice for all students, all teachers, or everyone in the community. One who is willing to host sessions just like this one in all cities where universities are located, so that she, and I agree with you, Harris, it should be a she, so that she or he understands the needs of each community the college or university is there to serve, because I believe universities are there to serve the community in addition to educating students. And one who values the worth of HBCUs and will work to sustain them and not try to pick them apart to see the negative things that are going on. But most importantly is a president who not only has good book sense, but also has good common sense and can relate to all students and their circumstances, who can relate to the faculty, everybody, despite who they are, no matter who they are, they can relate to them. Thank you so very much again for coming, and thank everybody else here for coming, because this is very important.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Taquan Lynch. I'm a rising social work major, senior here at North Carolina Central University. What I would like to see in a president is someone who works tireless at night to not just sit there and let the Board of Governors eliminate 49 offerings at across the UNC system. That's not good. Someone who doesn't let money dictate their decisions. I don't want to see a president who, somebody who gives their money to their campaign, that they dictate their decisions. They're just going off what they said. I want someone who worked tirelessly at night to make sure every student within the UNC system is afforded the same education and opportunities that UNC Chapel Hill students get, that NC State get, that ECU get. I want every student to be afforded the same opportunity, and that every school gets the same amount of money and doesn't just get cheated because of their name. I want somebody who cares. Somebody who's eager to get the job done under any circumstance. Thank you.
Thank you.
We've got a couple of comments that kind of underscore some of the other things we've heard tonight. We need a UNC president who understands the composition and diversity of faculty and students within the UNC system. We need a UNC president who understands that faculty working conditions are student learning conditions. We need a president who understands devotion to serving the public and people of North Carolina as part of the university core mission, and a global understanding of social, economic, and demographic changes, and sees UNC as developing global citizens.
Thanks, Carol. And these, Carol, for clarification for everyone, these were comments from social media, from Twitter. Okay.
Thank Good you. Evening. I am Philip Masila Mutisia, Professor of Education, School of Education here in North Carolina Central.
I have been in the system for the last 26 plus years. And of course, being a native of Kenya, transferred from here, I do have a passion for internationalization and globalization. And one of the major aspects I like to point out is there's a faculty professional development. I've not seen it. I've not seen any industry whereby you finish your, whether terminal degree or whatever, you don't get a refreshment or extra training. That we need a president who recognizes how to empower faculty, because it's, if I am not here in the classroom and my students are not here, none of you or of us will be here at all. And I think that needs to be emphasized. Empowering faculty is not a matter of giving them something. It's a matter of energizing, engaging, and with the shared governance and spirit of, someone mentioned the academic freedom and shared governance. That's something, that's an idea, concept we kind of talk about it. When we talk about transformation, meaning you change the within the system based on a vision, which is drives our institution, academy, to the next level, which is the 21st century. We cannot afford to be lagging behind. I know we are the best in system in the country. However, if you compare us in terms of caliber, performance, and how we are graduating programs now, and the paradigm shift, where the education of the higher education is going, we are imploding in the United States in general. And that should be someone who understands that and the mission of the academy. And to make sure that I am valued, the last comment is the fact that the last 6 years, I've never seen any increase in pay for faculty. Economy has increased, but there's a disconnect between the legislature, the Board of Governors, Board of Trustees, and the public education, and the boards of education. President need to understand that and to bring this together, because I should not be afraid of speaking my convictions, and because I'm the one who is the source of educating the foundation of the society. And if I'm afraid to express my views because I don't know what's going to happen to me, that's ideologically driven process, and we should not have it in the academy. So I just want to emphasize the faculty professional development and the diversifying, and don't give lip service to internationalization and globalization. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, it's suddenly become lonely at the microphones. Is there anyone else who would like to make a comment tonight? If there is, please come forward. While you're thinking about that, I would remind you that there are other ways that you can provide input this evening. The comment cards, if you have written comments that expanded on some of your ideas, or if you didn't speak and would like to leave those with us, please leave those at the registration table, or you can leave those with one of the SBTDC staff this evening. We'd be glad to have those. Again, there are multiple methods for providing input via email, text, and social media. We do have a couple of other speakers, although I think you have spoken before, haven't you?
Yes.
Okay. I'm gonna. We're limiting this to one comment per speaker, so I'm going to ask you if you would to not make another comment. I would appreciate it. Yes, ma'am.
I am E. Livonia Allison, a native of Durham, North Carolina. They called it Haytime, but basically I grew up in a block where we, on the right side was Dr. Jane Mills, MD. On the left side was Dr. Pearson, doctor of pharmacy. Two doors down was Dr. Fisher, PhD from the University of Chicago. What we have here is a person who actually went to college in Virginia, even though I was four blocks from North Carolina Central. My father finished North Carolina Central in 1926, 1 year after the state decided to give him some money, a little bit. The question that is before us, of course, I'm looking at this search committee. I'm looking for some more diversity. Jesus Christ, Lord, help us. I'm not going to go any further. No. I'm looking, you know what, everybody is a minority now. But I don't even want to get into that discussion. But the question I have, I left, came back from Virginia and went over to the University of North Carolina to take some courses. Raised my hand, couldn't get called on. So I decided to go on up to New York and did a master's and a doctorate at NYU. Then I came back, worked as a teacher. Then I taught here at North Carolina Central. Went to Chapel Hill as an administrator, a total new world. Unless we can come to grips with equity, not a cookie-cutting sameness, unless you bring somebody in here who understands that we are talking about equity, not equal, the same thing, because it's not the same. You meet institutions where they are and decide to put your resources, both fiscal and human resources, where your needs are the greatest. In 20-some years, we're going to have a whole lot more diversity when you change. Unless you are providing quality education to everybody who looks more like the epidermis and something about the follicles of hair, unless we do something about equitable treatment in terms of human resources and fiscal resources, we are working by selecting persons who are dancing to the political streams that the violin is playing with, M-O-N-E-Y. This board has got to understand that you've got to find someone who has the courage, the commitment, and the belief that that big dollar sign that comes in here during the political time, that's not going to sustain the kind of pride, the kind of accomplishment, the kind of success that you really want to have the University of North Carolina system. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Wanda Wilkins. I live in Durham.
Could you move a little closer to the mic, please? Thank you.
I'm Wanda Wilkins. I live in Durham. I graduated from UNC at Chapel Hill. I taught at Central and East Carolina universities. And I wanted to say that, student, did you get your last comment? I'll read whatever it was that you had to say. Thank you so much. Because we want the input of the students. I'm retired, I volunteer, I come and I can write to the Board of Governors and to anyone else. But I want someone who is nimble and able to maneuver with the Board of Governors, the General Assembly, and with the different presidents, someone who focuses on a usable education. I want someone, given the present president, I want someone who may be a short-termer, and he or she doesn't come to stay, or he has that notion or she has that notion that they may only have a short time to come to do what's necessary here. I want someone who focuses on graduating usable, workable students. And I want someone, if the idea is that we have to do remediation, who pays for it? We ultimately will pay for it. You're gonna pay now or you're gonna pay later. But someone who comes with some prior successes in those kinds of innovative ideas. And then, even though it's very painful, someone who can gently but very surgically, where it's necessary, combine, cut classes, departments, and programs, while still maintaining people's integrity, other job opportunities. 3 minutes. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Alicia Holland. I currently serve as the student body vice president. And it is important that the new president makes it a priority to access the efficiency and success rates of all UNC system institutions, advising procedures, to allow for students to be fully aware of requirements needed to receive their undergraduate degrees in 45 years. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, are there others? Would anyone else like to make a comment this evening?
Hello, thank you. My name is Salima Taylor. I am a senior North Carolina Central student, graduating in December. Much of what I wanted to see has been discussed, but I would really like a president that increases opportunities for students from various universities to interact with each other outside of academic settings. As a public health major, I'm increasingly realizing that rich experiences allow an individual to understand who they want to become, and that's what we're creating leaders. So although NC Central is very different from UNC, is very different from ECU, UNC State University, I think that interaction and that acceptance, along with the diversity working towards a common goal, will create grooves and new consciousness in our students. And I think that's an important aspect. It's not simply the financial aspect or the human resource aspect, but understanding that my degree and who I am does not matter simply because of the institution that I go to, but my ability to interact with any and everyone who I come into contact with. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, sir. Good evening.
Good evening. Hello, everyone. My name is Dennis Ellis, and I'm a proud alumnus of North Carolina Central University. I will make this short and sweet. The person that I would like to see to become the next UNC system president is a person who will be able to negotiate with all factions that they will have to deal with to make sure that our future students are educated. That means we'll have to have a person who's able to walk through landmines in order to talk with the General Assembly, regardless of party, political party. The one who will have the backbone to be able to say what they really feel to the UNC Board of Governors, whether they think they need it or not. Someone in which the students can feel that they have a university system that is worthy of their trust and allegiance and their hard work in the classroom. That is what I would like to see. And certainly, and it's been said many times, and I will say it one more time, the five HBCUs in the UNC system, they need to flourish as well. They are part of our citizens of North Carolina. They contribute much. Their alumni has contributed much and will continue to do so. So that person will have a very, very hard job to do because he or she will have to have the best juggling act that they can find in order to have everyone to listen to everyone. That's all, and thank you for your patience.
Thank you. Are there other comments? Okay. Just a reminder again, if you have written comments you'd like to leave with us tonight via the comment cards, you can please leave those on the registration table or leave those with an SBTDC staff member this evening. You also have access to other methods. You can email comments to unccearch@northcarolina.edu. you can use, and I'll try not to show my age and get it right, hashtag UNC Search. You can also text your comments to 919-590-3630. And we'd love to have your continued input after tonight. So thanks for all of your comments, and I will turn it over to Scott Doherty for closing remarks.
I want to thank you for your input tonight. It was very rich, quite diverse, a lot of things to think about. I can tell you this is our third forum. This was really robust in terms of contributions of very thoughtful input to folks who have a hard decision to make, they'll need to reflect on the observations and comments that you made in that process. So I think on their behalf, I thank you for being forthcoming with your remarks this evening. Thank you very much.